Okay, so number five, they ask you to find what is sine x and cosine x. This one should be no problem actually. Because this one is actually talking about which quadrant?
Trigonometry. Quadrant 2.
Very good. Quadrant 2.
Quadrant
1.
Oh no.
Take a look at your x. If you take a look at your x, this is acute, obtuse, reflex, or what?
Obtuse.
This is obtuse angle, right? And obtuse angle are actually quadrant. Now, can you see this angle R here?
Yeah.
If this is your somehow alpha, this must be what?
Theta.
Which is 180 minus
alpha.
Don't you think this really remind you so much of quadrant 2?
Yes.
Now, tell me, will the value of this sine alpha and sine theta the same?
No.
Try
sine. It is the same.
Try sine 30 is how much?
One.
Alright. What is sine?
150.
150.
1 over 2.
1 over 2. Is the same because you see the value are the same, but the sign are?
Might be different.
Correct. But in this case, sine. Quadrant 1 and quadrant 2 both are?
Sine.
Positive.
Yep.
So here, no problem. But cosine though, cosine in quadrant 2 is?
Negative.
But the value is the same. So the value of whatever here should be the same as this. So I just need to evaluate this. It's actually the same as sine alpha.
Yes.
What is my alpha here?
Sine
is so. So?
8 over 17.
Done. Cosine then?
However, it's negative.
Because cosine in quadrant 2 is?
Negative.
That's it.
Yeah.
Huh?
I flipped the whole thing.
Done. Goodbye.